in the real world, I kind of tend to, when I first meet people, put on a mask so that they don't really get to know me because I'm disabled.
A mask. It hides hope. It covers courage. It disguises dreams. This is a story about a special girl who takes off her mask to discover and develop her dreams. It's a story about Brookes Mask.
To take off the mask is like showing another dimension of me, my personality, my life. Different things that most people wouldn't see.
She's such an inspiration because she, you know, rolls with the punches and she makes life seem pretty easy.
Let people see the beauty that's inside of you and let people learn who you are, because the rest is not important.
Brooke Arnold is a promising poet. She shares her soul and inner beauty in poems about her favorite places and pastimes. This is her favorite poem, My Summer Home, a poem about summer camp. But just maybe, it's a poem about her life.
My Summer Home by Brooke Arnold. My summer home, it's not just any home. This is a one-of-a-kind home. It's a different world. No need to put on your mask. You can be yourself. No need to worry about anyone laughing at me. You can be yourself, because we're all the same at my summer home.
Brooke was born in a different world, a black and white world of disability, where she says she put on a mask of fear and uncertainty. She was born premature and weighed only 2 pounds, 9 ounces. Early on, doctors noticed something was wrong.
About 6 weeks after she was born, she had a stroke-type brain injury while she was in the hospital, and that's when they diagnosed cerebral palsy.
It's estimated about 10,000 babies and infants are diagnosed with cerebral palsy each year. Like them, Brooke was a prisoner of her body. On the outside, she was disabled. On the inside, she dreamed, and her mask hid those dreams.
It was very hard. It was very challenging to fit in, per se, and you know, I was just kind of out there, kind of down, just no hope, just kind of out there, just floating.
You know, I see her hurt, I see how people look, and I see how people react to her sometimes, and it's very hurtful as a parent.
But the hurt turned to hope when the Arnolds discovered this special place that helped turn Brooke's black and white world into color, a special place called McMains.
We meet children where they are and guide them where no one thought they could go, and that is to the world of possibilities.
Since 1954, the McMains Children's Developmental Center has taken thousands of kids where no one thought they could go. McMains, also known as UCP of Baton Rouge, is a United Way agency. It's named after Dr. Frank McMains, who always believed that children like Brooke can take off the mask of disability and put on the face of independence, acceptance, and normalcy. Mary Ann Knowles was one of the first McMains children. This is one of the braces she wore as a child, symbolic of the mask she was able to take off.
If I wouldn't have gone to this center, I could just probably be crawling around on the floor somewhere. You know, I wouldn't be functional.
Mary Ann now has a family, a career, a dream come true to help others like her. She's a special ed teacher, helping other children reach their potential.
I get upset sometimes because I think some of the special ed teachers, they just treat them like they're a piece of wood. They're not people, but there's something in there. They are people. Just have to pull that out.
McMains has now become a beacon of hope for many other children, trying to overcome everything from cerebral palsy and severe speech and language disabilities to autism, ADHD, and Down syndrome. Isabella is just starting her journey here. She was diagnosed with multiple disabilities. Not long ago, she couldn't raise her head, stand, walk, or even talk. But look at her now.
When you're told your child has a disability and then you're left like floundering in the water, they were my lifeline, her lifeline, and her hope for the future.
Hope that comes through physical therapy, educational therapy, occupational therapy, speech and language therapy. McMains is also the only place in the Baton Rouge area that offers the Thera suit, what some call the miracle suit. Intense therapy with this special suit helps kids correct their muscle and bone alignment. It gives them strength to do some remarkable things.
We give them the strength and we give them that confidence to remove the mask.
McMains is also fun. The kids get to remove their mask through innovative social, recreational, and educational programs, like the Capable Arts Camp, a camp where everyone becomes an artist. Everyone creates a masterpiece. Our kids also enjoy therapeutic gymnastics in Tigertown, thanks to a special partnership between the center and LSU. And they even ride bikes, specially adapted three-wheeled bikes, on the No Such Thing as Impossible bike ride, part of the Wheels to Succeed program.
This place has taught me a lot about friendship and helping others. And I don't know, it's a special place in my heart because these people, they did a lot for me. They went above and beyond what they're supposed to do.
And just like her poem, Brooke says she can be herself at McMains. After graduating from therapy here, she's found independence and acceptance. She's an honor student, a mentor at school, and like Marianne, she wants to be a special ed teacher. She's also an inspiration. She worked with therapists to get a grant to purchase a wheelchair swing for the center, helping many other kids take off their mask. For her efforts, Brooke was named Hero of the Month.
I really was really surprised, you know, because I don't see it as being a hero. I just see it as, you know, lending a helping hand wherever I can.
There was a time I packed my dreams away, living in a shell, hiding from myself. There was a time when I was so afraid. I thought I'd reach the end. Baby, that was then. But I am made of more than
generations of McMains children no longer hide their hope, cover their courage, disguise their dreams. Like this promising poet, who has shown all of us that you can be yourself, because we are all the same. That outlook and this special place called McMains have helped her take off Brooke's mask.
Smile.